Hey, students, welcome to the most exciting demonstration of this course. I'm sure you are going to love it because you guys have been asking for this functionality to handle multiple clients on the server for a while now. So I have finally prepared the lectures and let us get the Visual Studio started. I'm going to start the server which we created in the last lecture. And then I'm going to the client software bin directory. Over here, I have created three copies of the client software just to simulate multiple client instances. But first of all, let us just start listening on the server. And now I am going to start debug and TCP client 01. I will go to the other directory and start the other client. And the third directory and start the third client. I would love to say that if anyone of you has got ideas to like improve the server, for example, show messages like, okay, I've started listening, all right, so disable this button, do that, feel free to do it. I tried my level best to keep the course focused and to do as minimum things as possible to just impart you the basic concept. So fancy bells and whistles are always there. You can play around with them. So now I'm going to start a client software here. Actually, I have already started one, so I'm going to connect it. It's like that. So server says a client is connected and it is showing me a pair of IP and port. Here you see. Now I go to the second client instance and I say connect. So another client is connected and its IP and port are being displayed here. Let us connect the third client as well. So the third client is also connected now and we can simply start sending data from any client, like any data here, and I say send. You see data is received on the server from first client. It is also showing you which client has actually sent the data. Let's go to the other client and send the data. Again, the data has arrived on the server. And the third one, anything goes. Okay, so that's as simple as that. And now I'm going to send data from the server to the client. I have clicked an instance of a client on the server form. And I will click the payload text box and say something, anything like whatever. And let me see. Now I click the send button. Here is the client. So you can see that the data has arrived on this client instance. I can do the same with other clients. Like now the data has arrived on the other clients. So basically now we have the capability of selecting a client from this list box and send data to that specific client. Ain't that wonderful? Looks really beautiful. Yeah, it does look beautiful. So there you go. And what happens if, like, suppose I disconnect a client? So when I will disconnect a client, that client's IP address and port are going to disappear from this client list. So let me close one at random. I close one. There is an error on the server. It's okay. That's an exception block. That's a try catch block. There you see the client address is gone. That's what we wanted. I will close another one and another one is gone. Let's go back and start another instance of a client like this and say connect. Now you see the client is connected again and the server will be able to send it data. Here, no, this is the one I killed. So that is all for the demo. I believe you would have enjoyed it and I believe you are going to find it useful. This is a bonus lecture, so Udemy allows me to introduce you to my other courses. I recently launched another new course about Windows Service Programming. A coupon code link for that course is given in the description of the course title, and the coupon code are also going to be shown on the screen. So please feel free to join that course, and thank you very much for watching.